Unfortunately, the eco-bastards didn't share the wealth. And worse, no hot granola babe rocked my world. I regretted my decision almost immediately. But they did give me a badger saw for my trouble. And that's how I joined the Catharsis Police Department. And surprisingly, the girl cops are not all dykes. Just mostly. Oh shit, now there's no one left alive to give me my money. Fuck. So I wandered out of the shop, not sure what to do next. Just then, I happened upon a guy training another guy how to use catnip to catch HIV-infected cats. Apparently, some sort of science experiment had gone awry in the previous game and rendered the local cat population a bit aggressive. Fortunately, the trainee didn't have any aptitude for the job, so I got put in charge of the operation. Of course, I was grossly overqualified. But you know what a sucker I am for humanitarian causes. The guy warned me not to press alt-fire and accidentally snort the catnip kids, then sent me off to catch diseased insano cats while he called his lawyer. What I didn't know was that the local Dirty Sanchez Mexi Sushi concern had dibs on the local cat population, and they didn't take too kindly to interlopers plundering their natural resources. They made it clear in no uncertain terms that I should go away, permanently, but I really needed the cash, this was a cause that meant so much to me, so there was no way I was letting the poor syphilis-infected kitties down. It turned out I was pretty good at that job. Unfortunately, upper management had just experienced a shake-up. And long story short, I once again failed to get paid. This was definitely beginning to feel like a theme. Somehow I found myself at a political rally in front of the town's shitty little mall. Mayor Chomo was giving some weird speech about homeland security, family values, and winning the war on drugs. Sounded like he was practicing for bigger things. I just realized the mayor was the fucking porn shop guy with the ridiculous Mario disguise when Vince called with a hot job prospect.
Hey dude, how's your balls hanging? Look, I got a job for you. My head postal babe, Jen Walcott, is doing a promo at the mall. But a regular bodyguard got eaten by a friggin' feral cat this morning.
No problemo. Security is my mother's maiden name. Or at least it was on a tattoo she had.
Okay, I'm here with the man simply known as the Postal Dude.
I hate that fucking name, by the way.
Okay, do you have a real name?
I forget. Kids, don't do drugs, okay?
Haha, too much green health herb?
Or meth. Just kidding, kids. Do as I say, not as I do.
Okay, well, I'm sure my listeners would like to know how you ended up in your current surprising situation.
Or not so surprising, depending on how well you know me.
Right, haha. Okay, so I've read that you were in paradise before it was completely devastated by the possibly terror-related nuclear incident?
Yeah, due to an unfortunate miscommunication with my subprime mortgage broker, I was forced to relocate to a nicer neighborhood with my extremely beautiful wife. I'd just been hired by one of America's premier video game companies. Now, management decided that I was working too hard and needed a sabbatical.
Nothing personal, man, but you're fired.
But I just started yesterday.
So I used the time to check some errands off my list. Got Gary Coleman's autograph. That was pretty sweet. Picked up some steaks. Played with elephants, went to confession, and visited my dad's grave, because that's how I roll.
Speaking of religion, weren't you at the Church of Dave compound during the massacre?
Yeah, it was Uncle Dave's birthday. I got him one of those bad-touch crotchy figures. Those things were harder to get than erato-asphyxiation Elmo. Anyway, awesome party at Dave's until the man showed up. I'm pretty sure they had the wrong address, though. Anyway, it wasn't so much a religious cult as it was a cheap scam for Dave to hook up with Christian chicks, you know? Now, apparently they go nuts for the whole, I am the reincarnation of Jehovah. Kneel down and watch me play a wicked guitar solo shtick. Anyway, after my unfortunate firearms accident, my beautiful wife left me. I was devastated. By then, the neighborhood was lousy with sewer Taliban. The Mad Cow Tourette zombie epidemic broke out, so me and Champ decided it was time to get out of paradise and enjoy a change of scenery.
Okay, I'm here with the man simply known as the Postal Dude.
I hate that fucking name, by the way.
Okay, do you have a real name?
I forget. Kids, don't do drugs, okay?
Haha, too much green health herb?
Or meth. Just kidding, kids. Do as I say, not as I do.
Okay, well, I'm sure my listeners would like to know how you ended up in your current surprising situation.
Or not so surprising, depending on how well you know me.
Right, okay, so I've read that you were in paradise before it was completely devastated by the possibly terror-related nuclear incident?
Yeah, due to an unfortunate miscommunication with my subprime mortgage broker, I was forced to relocate to a nicer neighborhood with my extremely beautiful wife. I'd just been hired by one of America's premier video game companies. Now, management decided that I was working too hard and needed a sabbatical, so I used the time to check some errands off my list. Got Gary Coleman's autograph. That was pretty sweet. Picked up some steaks, played with elephants, went to confession, and visited my dad's grave, because that's how I roll.
Speaking of religion, weren't you at the Church of Dave compound during the massacre when the ATF tried to execute warrants related to drug trafficking and weapons charges?
Not to mention the possible unlawful relations with minors. Yeah, it was Uncle Dave's birthday. I got him one of those bad touch crotchy figures. Those things were harder to get than Erato Asphyxiation Elmo. Anyway, awesome party at Dave's until the man showed up. I'm pretty sure they had the wrong address, though. Anyway, it wasn't so much a religious cult as it was a cheap scam for Dave to hook up with Christian chicks, you know? Now, apparently they go nuts for the whole, I am the reincarnation of Jehovah. Kneel down and watch me play a wicked guitar solo shtick. Anyway, after my unfortunate firearms accident, my beautiful wife left me. I was devastated. By then, the neighborhood was lousy with sewer Taliban. The Mad Count Tourette's zombie epidemic broke out, so me and Champ decided it was time to get out of paradise and enjoy a change of scenery.
Right, so you were at the Paradise Municipal Bridge when the tragedy struck?
Well, that was fun, but unfortunate. All my customers got scared away, so I can't pay you. But go ahead and keep the taser and the shovel as a token of my appreciation. See you later, dude.
I arrived at the Ecotologist compound and met their leader, Al. He proceeded to sell me on a swanky, high-level position in their produce operation. Good thing there were no survivors from Cash Mart to identify me. Those guys would have been pretty pissed at me for shanking all their buddies in the previous mission. Now, my new career in eco-friendly produce acquisition was cut short by the untimely appearance of Al-Qaeda.
This is it, my brothers. We stand upon the cusp of glorious destiny. Go now. Jihad!
Well, the ecotologists put up a pretty good fight for a bunch of spindly, semi-gay tree worshippers. Sorry, I'm lying. They were getting pwned. It was clear they were going to need professional help. Al was pretty proud of his Africanized bee hybrids and showed me how to lob hives full of them at the bad guys. Then he handed me an armful of the things and buggered off to cower in his panic room. Al was so happy that he gave me some beehives for the road. The tree-hugging bastard also forgot to pay me, probably due to all the green health herb they grow down there. Kids, stay in school. ecotologists were a little sensitive about the friendly fire and asked me to leave the compound. Obviously, I didn't get paid. Hello? Anyone home? I'm here about the temp job. Hello? Hi, I'm Ashton Kutcher, and you've just been punked. Hello?
Hey, man. Good to meet you. Put it in, pal.
Apparently, it was cold and flu season, and Ron's patrons were littering the floor with
shit, not you bitches again, what the fuck?
Ron's establishment was besieged by a cadre of angry hockey moms. These chicks were on a self-righteous mission to clean up the moral turpitude of catharsis. Fortunately, they had an Achilles heel, an intense aversion to sticky Kleenex wads. Maybe they were allergic. I pity their husbands.
Christmas, is that it? Are they gone? After seeing that shit, I'll never look at Milf Wrangler the same way again. From now on, it's strictly Bailey legal for me. Anyway, nice work, man. That shop bag looks good on you. Tell you what, you just hang on to it, and if you ever need any extra cash, just drop by for more Snotwad Patrol. Cool?